The next topic after concentration term is, we are going to study about the solubility of a solute. So let us see, what is this solubility? Solubility means what? You take any substance, let it be A. How to define the solubility of this substance A? Solubility is nothing but, it is the maximum amount of that substance. Maximum amount of that substance. It may be substance A, maximum amount of that substance, or maximum amount of substance A. Substance A, which can be dissolved in. Which can be dissolved in. Which can be dissolved in. Specified amount of solvent at specified temperature. At specified temperature. For any substance, its solubility is its maximum amount that can be dissolved in specified amount of solvent at specified temperature. No need to take A always. Any substance you can take. It may be sugar or salt or any substance. Solubility of that substance is its maximum amount which can be dissolved in specified amount of solvent at specified temperature. For this also I will give one example. You take 100 milliliter of water. You take 50 gram of sugar. Can you dissolve all the 50 gram in 100 milliliter of water? It is not possible to dissolve all the 50 gram in 100 ml of water. Maximum, let it be 5 gram. 5 gram is the mass of sugar which can be dissolved in 100 ml of water. So 5 gram is the maximum amount of sugar. It's the maximum amount of sugar. Maximum amount of sugar which can be dissolved in 100 milliliter of water. So you cannot dissolve 6 gram now. It's not possible to dissolve 6 gram at that same temperature for that same volume 100 ml. You cannot dissolve 6 gram. You can dissolve only 5 gram. Addition of even a single crystal of sugar does not dissolve in 100 milliliter of water. So now 5 gram is its maximum amount. 5 gram is the maximum amount of sugar can be dissolved in 100 ml of water. So it is its solubility. For any substance you can define like this. 5 gram is not the exact amount. Just I have taken one example, that's all. You can dissolve 6 gram. If 6 gram is the maximum amount, 7 gram you cannot dissolve. But 5 gram you can dissolve. You can add 1 more gram to get its solubility. Is it clear? Yes. Now, the solubility of any substance depends upon various factors. There are 3 factors. Mainly there are 3 factors which affects the solubility. And that first one is nature of solute and solvent. The nature of solute and solvent affect the solubility of solute, or which affects the solubility. Next, temperature, and third one is pressure. Now let us discuss these factors for different types of solutions. How these 3 factors affect solubility of various types of solutes in solvents. So that first one, solubility of solid in liquid. Solubility of solid in liquid. Now let us discuss these factors on this. How solubility of solid is affected by these 3 factors. I will give you some examples here. You take sodium chloride, NaCl. You take glucose. You take naphthalene. Naphthalene. You take anthracene, naphthalene and anthracene. Here NaCl and glucose are soluble in water. Naphthalene and anthracene are insoluble in water, but they are soluble in benzene. Sodium chloride and glucose are insoluble in benzene. They are insoluble in benzene. Why? What is the reason for this? Sodium chloride and glucose are soluble in water. Naphthalene and anthracene are soluble in benzene. So what is the reason for this? The reason is, we know like dissolves in like. That means polar solutes can be dissolved in polar solvent. Non-polar solutes can be dissolved in non-polar solvents. In order to dissolve any solute in a given solvent, their molecular interactions or type of interactions between them must be same. Means in polar solutes, there is interaction between the charges. In polar solvents, there is interaction between the charges. So it's a charged one, it has a dipole moment or it has polarity. If this solute also has some polarity, it gets dissolved in that solvent. Means polar solutes can be dissolved in polar solvents. Non-polar solutes can be dissolved in non-polar solvents. So in general, we say like dissolves in like. In order to dissolve any solute in a given solvent, the molecular interactions or type of interaction between them must be same. Polar-polar or non-polar-non-polar interactions. Not between polar-non-polar, polar-non-polar. So this is insoluble, but polar-polar are soluble, non-polar-non-polar, they are soluble. Next, let us see, what happens if you put any solute into a solvent? What happens if you put any solute into a solvent? If you put any solute into a solvent, there is a dissolution. Dissolution occurs. What do you mean by dissolution? When you put some amount of solute into solvent, the solute that you have taken in the solvent gets dissolved in it and its concentration in the solution increases. If you put any solute in a given solvent, if you put any solute into a solvent, that solute gets dissolved in that solvent. It gets dissolved in this solvent and the concentration of solute in the solvent or in the solution increases. When you put any solute in the solvent, the solute gets dissolved in the solvent, its concentration of solute in the solution increases. And this process is known as dissolution. Okay, shortly what you can say, when you put solute in the solvent, there is a dissolution. Dissolution, what is dissolution? I have explained it. Now, during this process of dissolution, what happens? When you are adding solute into the solution, the solute particles which you are adding, collide with the solute particles which are already present in the solution. I'll explain using this diagram. Now we have a solution of certain solute. In that we have some solute particles. You are adding the same solute particle into the solution. When you are adding this solute particle into the solution, these solid solute particles collide with these solute particles which are already present in the solution, and by which some of the solute particles will come out from the solution. And this process is known as crystallization. I have written here. That process is known as crystallization. So during dissolution, two processes occur. When you are dissolving a solute in a solvent, two processes occur simultaneously. One is dissolution and second one is crystallization. During dissolution, solute particle enters into the solution, which increases the concentration of solute in the solution. At the same time, the solid solute particles collide with the solute particles which are present in the solution. The solid solute particle collide with these and they separate out from the solution. These solute particle separates out from the solution, leaving behind the solvent, which leads to crystallization. So there are two processes, dissolution and crystallization. So they are occurring simultaneously in a solution. Now, during the dissolution, equilibrium is attained between the solute and solution. how this equilibrium will be attained. I will explain. The number of solute molecules which are entering into the solution becomes equal to number of solute particles which are separating out from the solution. This is the dynamic equilibrium. Why this happens, you know. Here, when you dissolve any solute in the solvent, two processes occurs. One is dissolution and second one is crystallization. During equilibrium state, the number of solute particles entering into the solution, the number of solute particles which gets dissolved in the solution becomes equal to number of particles which are coming out from the solution. That is, rate of dissolution becomes equal to rate of crystallization. At this state, the concentration of solution remains same. At this state, concentration of solution remains same. So now this type of solutions are known as saturated solutions. Saturated solution. So I will explain this dynamic equilibrium once again. At equilibrium, for example, continuously 2 gram of solute is entering into the solution state. At the same time, 2 gram of solute particles will come out from the solution, leaving behind the solvent. The rate of dissolution and rate of crystallizations are equal. This is state of dynamic equilibrium, means both forward and backward process takes place simultaneously in the same rate. Now, due to this, concentration of solution remains the same. It does not change after attaining equilibrium. Such solutions are known as saturated solutions. What do you mean by saturated solution? In a saturated solution, concentration does not change, it remains the same. What do you mean by saturated solution? Saturated solution is nothing but it's a solution in which no more solute can be dissolved. No more solute can be dissolved. No more solute can be dissolved at given temperature. No more solute can be dissolved at given temperature. So this is a definition of saturated solution. But as you increase the temperature, when you increase the temperature, dissolution increases. You can dissolve more amount of solute, but we are keeping the temperature as constant. Here we use one more term, that is unsaturated solution. Unsaturated solution. Unsaturated solution means it's a solution in which we can dissolve some amount of solute. This is a solution in which we can dissolve solute. The solution in which we can dissolve solute. We can dissolve solute at given temperature. At given temperature. You can continue the addition of solute here till we get saturated solution. After getting saturated solution, no more solute can be dissolved. If you add further amount of solute into the same solution, you can find or you can see the deposition of crystals at the bottom of that solution. You can find some crystals depositing at the bottom, so which indicates that solution has reached a saturated state.